or, you know, seeing on a map a red line and you're wondering, you know, what does this mean? What are they taking away from me? So I think these kinds of visualization technologies really enable citizens to, you know, get a feel for what's happening, which lets them, you know, point out the things that they like and be more precise about things that they don't like, as opposed to kind of just taking a general anti-development stance. And lastly, technology can also make a difference by bringing in elements of gamification. So Block by Block is an organization that works with the creators of Minecraft, the game, and UN Habitat to reach out to poorer communities worldwide to engage those very communities, and especially the younger people in those communities, to reimagine their public spaces. So they run workshops and teach kids and teenagers how to play this game and help them basically prepare proposals to the city officials on what they would like their public spaces to look like. And the city officials then take the proposals in the form of Minecraft work, and they then implement those designs in the real public spaces. So again, using technology and games to reach audiences and participants that you otherwise would not be able to get. So just to round up, I asked the question, what's needed? I think we need to recognize the need to depart from the status quo. I think if we all agree that something's not good enough, we need to start thinking, then what can we do about it? Oftentimes, as a technologist, when we approach organizations, including public sector organizations, we can arrive at a consensus that something is not good enough, but oftentimes the response is, you know, the solution that you're bringing us is a nice to have, and we don't really have the time or energy to invest in a pilot or, you know, to test it out. And I think that kind of, you know, mindset is a barrier to adopting some of these newly emerging technologies. And along similar lines, culture change that encourages creative solution seeking. So I think there are brilliant individuals in a lot of organizations, including local authorities, who have amazing ideas to shape things up. So for instance, Plymouth City Council did a really innovative and fun thing with their new local plan. They ran podcasts to engage with their citizens. They, you know, developed a very interactive web-based version of their local plans, making it very digestible and accessible and attractive to the young people as well. And when they took that local plan to the inspector to get it examined, they were essentially asked to remove those elements in which they had innovated because they were not, you know, fit to be assessed. And of course, there are regulatory and statutory requirements that we all need to meet. But if the message from, you know, those bodies are that, you know, stop innovating because, you know, it's not fitting the box, then I think that's a dampener on the brilliant minds that we have in local authorities. And I think, just, again, you know, creative solutions, they might sound outrageous, but if we don't have, you know, better alternatives, why not consider them? So, you know, the example of Minecraft, that was, you know, really kind of far out there, but, you know, why not Minecraft? What are we doing now that's better than Minecraft that is reaching out to young people? Or, you know, what are we doing now? And, you know, if we recognize that it's not good enough, you know, why not Minecraft? And along all of these lines, I think it's absolutely necessary that we get buy-in from public sector leadership, senior management. And also, in addition, I think more open data would help in general to empower citizens to, you know, play around with public sector information, with the data to run different analyses. And also, open data encourages innovation. So startups like ourselves rely on local authorities adopting a very open data, transparency kind of approach for us to play with that data to see what we can do. I think we need commitment to digital literacy, as was raised earlier. It's a big concern whenever we try to do something technology-based. You know, there's going to be a big part of the population that's going to be, you know, excluded from this, and that is very true, but I think that is an argument to then commit to digital literacy as opposed to hold back innovation. And obviously the argument here is not that, you know, we have everything sort of replaced, but that we start sort of implementing things step by step. know, running things in tandem for a long time. And I think we also need conversations about, you know, the planning system in general, to bring it back to planning, not just the planning notices. It's very easy to point the finger at, you know, the silly planning notice that's on the lamppost and, you know, have that be the problem, when we are probably dealing with the problem that's much larger in scale. So we have a planning system that was designed in the 1940s, and you know, we live in a world that's absolutely different. So it's, you know, not just that our planning notices are on paper, but you know, do we have a system where we're engaging with our citizens sufficiently, not just at, you know, certain decision points, but what can we do to really think about the planning system to bring it to meet the needs of today. And I think finally we also need conversations like the one we're having this evening about democracy, because it's not just about technology, it's not just about, you know, the little mechanisms that are the issue, but really talking about is representative democracy enough, or is it some form of direct democracy that we want, especially in planning as we run sort of direct consultations. And if that's what we want, you know, is the way we run consultations fit for our intent for that kind of democracy? And especially so because if we do not talk about, you know, the planning system as a whole and democracy more in depth and just focus on those mechanisms and the technologies and what we can put where, we'll very much end up with, you know, stupid things in stupid places, which is not what we want. So I'll just end the presentation with this quote I found from a research report. When participation meets the expectations of today's citizen, those citizens will get involved. Thank you.
Authorities as an online consultation tool, if it is not confidential information, what local authorities, can you give us a few names? Okay. And secondly, is it only for the planning? Is it used as an online consultation tool in other fields by local authorities?
Yeah, so I just included it because I had come across it. I have no relationship to Common Place.
Okay.
If you go on their website, they actually feature a few examples of local authorities that are using Common Place. I think Southwick probably, yeah, they're everywhere. Yeah, Southwick, and I believe it's not just in planning, but general sort of user engagement, citizen engagement type of thing.
Yes, can I ask a slightly similar question to the second part of that question? Obviously, people don't always like having big tablets, new housing estate next to them, what's important often in the discussion is not necessarily the building itself, but the socioeconomic, the jobs, the health, the educational benefits that can accrue from a more sustainable community. Are there packages and methods that are used in a similar way to the ones you described here that would describe those sorts of benefits and put a bigger picture in terms?
Sure, if there is a platform out there that can hold up as a case study where they, you know, did really well in the realm of, you know, inclusivity and getting a diversity of representation. I think there just are so much room for improvement that for now we're celebrating capturing the younger generation. And I think once we sort of get to a certain level of, all right, we're getting a good, you know, representation when it comes to age, I think then we'll start speaking more about reaching to different, you know, socioeconomic and or ethnic communities using technology.
No, I've actually had it look really, really good, and I can see how it could develop into that sort of field.
Yeah, and I think these platforms could really be used for those kinds of purposes if community groups, certain community interest groups, then really, you know, stand by these platforms and, you know, send them out to their listservs or, you know, their community members. But yeah, it is to be seen.
Any more questions?